There's no doubt the R32 GTR is a popular package when it comes to circuit racing. One of the downsides with that GTR chassis, though, is it's inherently pretty heavy. Xtreme GTR have done an amazing job of building a lightweight R32 GTR with the use of a huge amount of carbon fibre. Every single panel on this car is built from dry carbon by Topstage Composites. Now, unfortunately, Xtreme GTR haven't had an amazing run here at World Time Attack, and the car suffered from an engine bay fire last year before it even managed to get a single timed lap on the board. So this created a huge amount of work for the team over the last 12 months, with essentially everything from the firewall forward being destroyed in that fire. So we've got the car behind us, it's been completely rebuilt and it's ready to run here at World Time Attack Challenge 2018. We're going to go over what has gone into this amazing quality build, and it starts with the RB28 engine. Now, this isn't built around a stock RB26 block though. At the sort of power levels you need to be competitive in the open class here at World Time Attack, the stock cast iron block has been proven to be pretty unreliable. The team at Xtreme GTR went straight for the top shelf with a billet aluminium engine block. Now, this has been fitted with a Nitto 2.8-litre stroker crank, a set of Carrillo rods, and a set of pistons from SPS. The advantages of the billet block obviously include its strength first and foremost. Now, it's fitted with a set of ductile iron sleeves. They're both stronger and thicker than the stock sleeves in the factory cast iron block. The deck surface is also thicker than the stock block, and this helps improve the ability to hold the cylinder head onto the engine block, improving that head gasket seal, which is so important when you're running very high boost levels. This is also aided by a larger set of head studs that go into the billet block. Now, the other aspect with the billet block is that it's also a lot lighter than the cast iron stock block. Topping the cylinder block is a fully race-prepared RB26 cylinder head. And this is really one of the keys to getting airflow both in and out of that engine. On the exhaust side, we've got a Precision 6870 turbocharger, which is probably a little bit smaller than some of the teams at this level are running. And really here, it's all about balancing the power delivery with the ultimate power level. It's all about getting a wide enough power band or rev range that's usable around the racetrack. At the moment, the car is running approximately 950 wheel horsepower, running around about 32 PSI of boost on E85 fuel. The compressed air exiting that turbocharger runs through a front-mounted PWR intercooler before heading into a Hypertune Plenum. As is common with RB26-based engines at this sort of power level, the factory individual throttle bodies have been ditched in favour of a single plenum fronted with a large drive-by-wire throttle body. The electronics package controlling the car all comes from MoTeC and includes an M150 ECU in charge of the engine control, a pair of MoTeC PDM15 power distribution modules, which are in control of distributing power to all of the circuits for both the engine and the chassis. On top of this, there's a MoTeC C187 dash logger, and this doubles as both a driver display as well as a central logging unit where all of the data from the chassis and the engine can be stored and analysed. Backing the engine and getting that power to the ground is an Albin's ST6 six-speed sequential transmission. Now, this is still mated to the factory Nissan R32 four-wheel drive transfer case, so the car still retains four-wheel drive. That Albin's six-speed sequential gearbox also makes use of a strain gauge gear lever, which communicates to the MoTeC M150 ECU. This lets the ECU know when the driver is pulling back on the lever requesting an upshift, and then the ECU can perform an ignition or fuel cut to allow a clutchless full throttle shift to be completed. On the downshift, the driver can concentrate solely on braking, and the auto blip is controlled via the ECU and that drive-by-wire throttle when the driver pushes the gear lever forward. Now, while Xtreme GTR haven't had the best luck so far at World Time Attack, We'd class this car as one of the tidiest and best built examples we've seen, and we really hope that they get to show the world exactly what this car is capable of tomorrow in competition.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up, and if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.